two, get down. Paid the cost to be the boss. Paid the cost to be the boss. I paid the cost to be the boss.
You're now tuned in to the CEO Ro Experience. I'm your gracious host, CEO Ro. And of course, today we have another banger, man. This individual is a very artistic, she's like an artistic butterfly to me. That's like what I get in the vibes that I get from this sister. I first came across her talents on the Fly Team Fridays. She had a video that she submitted. We do the top five videos of the month. And I was really just blown away by her efforts and the artistic creativity that went into the whole thing. I was really happy. I was like, yeah, that sister put the work in for that.
Thank you.
It was different. So, you know, from there, you know, I've heard the tracks. I heard the Confessionals, acoustic version of Confessionals. I love it. That's my vibe, of course. Mm-hmm. You dig what I'm saying? So I had to have her on the CEO Real Experience so that I could share her as well as her talents with my audience. So with no further ado, who do we have on the CEO Real Experience today?
Slay Myers.
Yes, Slay Myers.
Hi.
Yes, Slay Myers. No doubt. It's a pleasure to have you, sister, on my platform. Of course, we're going to get into your business. But before we do all that, we cannot break tradition here on the CEO Real Experience. So we created a signature drink on behalf of each of our guests. So we created the Slayhama Mama. You dig what I'm saying?
Slayhama Mama.
Courtesy of the CEO Real Experience. Cheers. Now you can crack that drink.
Hey.
Tell me what you think.
Ooh, I know it's going to be fire.
No seal. Yeah, the seal. That's real. The seal is real.
I usually don't do this before I sing, but we're going to have a good time today.
Yeah.
Why you do that?
Because, I mean, that's what we do
Why
here.
You do that?
That's what we do here.
Slay Hama, it slays.
No doubt, that's what we do here. Well, let me get it together over here. You know, let me get it together. I don't know, mic and fell.
Oh, okay, this is good. Here. It's nice and sweet.
Yes.
I like fruity drinks like that.
Yes, I thought you would like it.
Yeah. It's like a slow drip. It hits you slowly.
Ooh,
like,
a slow drip.
Because it's sweet, you know, you just drinking like it's juice, and it's like, ooh, feel pretty good.
Yes, now CEO Ro is back in full effect.
Okay.
And I have my sister again, the queen, Slay Myers,
in
the building. You dig what I'm saying? Thank you for having me.
Can I say, yes. I love, not to cut you, I love how you describe me as an artistic butterfly.
Mm-hmm.
I love that. You really get it.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. I really, it's funny because that's kind of like how I, when they ask me, it's like.
That's the description. That's the, like, when you want to describe how you are or who you are on the artistic side as an artist.
Magical, like youthful,
colorful
and very like almost like, you know,
natural,
and
beautiful.
I love that. No thank doubt. You for picking that up. That means I'm okay, cool. We're doing the right things.
Cheers.
Hey, we're doing the right things. We're not delusional. People can see it too.
This Slayhama Mama, baby, this joint is delicious. You hear me? But let's get into this interview. Let's get into why you are here on the CEO Ro Experience.
Hey.
So please let the people know, again, who you are, what it is you do, and where you're from.
Okay. Hello, everybody. I'm Slay Myers. I'm a singer. I'm a songwriter. I'm an artistic butterfly, as this fine gentleman just said a few minutes ago. I'm here to talk about my music, my journey in music, what I have out so far, what I have coming out very soon. And I'm here to share the good vibes with people, because people always ask me what kind of music I make, and I like to say I make music to raise the vibes. You know, I just told you, like, you feel magical, you remember magic again, you feel capable, you feel like, oh yeah, I can do that. If you listen to my music, you'll always feel like that. And I just talk about the real, you know, I didn't want to admit this before, but I'm a very sensitive person.
Okay.
And I feel a lot. I don't look like I do because I be so chill. I'm an Aquarius, so we cool and calm.
Okay,
you're
an Aquarius. Okay.
We're calm and collected.
You like to go with the flow.
Yeah, but inside it's like a lot.
Right.
It's a lot in there.
So a lot going on.
I embrace that over time, and I just let the music speak.
Right.
If you listen to one of my songs and talk to me in person, it's like, oh, it's the same person. I'm like, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
if I have a conversation with you and it inspires me, I might write a song about it later. So, yeah.
Well, you already was diving into like two of the questions that I had for you. But again, we're going to touch on all that good stuff. We're going to go into a little bit more detail, so to speak. When did you recognize that you wanted to be an artist?
Well, I've always been like creative. It's so weird. I remember doing this play when I was like 5. I'm originally from Queens, New York, too, by the way.
Queens, shouts out to Queens.
I've been in Philly.
You know what I'm saying? Queens,
I like to say Queens and Philly because I was born in Queens. I left when I was 12. My mom left. You know, she had 2 kids to raise. It was expensive in New York, so she came to Philly.
Yes, it is.
I don't know how she did. I look at her every day and say, I don't know how you did it, but I appreciate you. I really do.
The brownstones?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I've always been creative. I have this really vivid memory of being in like kindergarten. Okay. And they were making like masks out of like paper mache and like glue and stuff.
Okay.
And I remember, I think I was a bird in the play because I remember the smell and it was like still cold on my face.
Okay.
And I still remember that. And I remember that was like my first taste of like being in front of people and I liked it.
And you loved it.
But my mom put me in modeling school when I was like 8. She always put me in something because she always told me I was like high energy or whatever.
Right.
But I didn't discover that I could sing until I was 14. I started off as an actress.
Okay.
Drama.
Yeah, she's a drama major.
Drama.
Yeah. You'll put it on. You know how to pour it on, should I say.
I told you, I feel my feelings, man.
Yeah, you can pour it on a little bit. Yeah.
I'll be in my feelings, but I embrace it nowadays. But I didn't discover I could sing until I was 14. Everybody's always like, what? People, they do it when they're like 5 and 6. I was like, I discovered everything late about, I'm a late bloomer. That's why I still am so childlike. And
so what was that one song that you were singing that you were like, yeah, I'm hitting all these notes?
You know what? I feel my very first, one of my very first CDs, I used to have CD players. Y'all know about that.
Yeah.
I used to have CD players and I had the Now 8 CD, the legal mix CD.
Right.
And they had Aaliyah on there. They had Jessica Simpson. Okay. I don't know what I sounded like, but I know I used to have the headphones on. I used to be singing my butt off because I liked how it sounded.
Right.
But I didn't know yet until I started listening to Mariah Carey.
Oh.
Emancipation of Mimi. This was way back in 2000. It's like God was like pushing me.
Oh.
He was like, you're getting closer.
Because Mariah, you know, Emancipation of Mimi, that's the comeback for her. She showed her behind on that one.
Listen. I like to make a joke. I always say, like, God was pushing me towards the divas. He was like, all right, you discovered this thing.
Yeah.
Now listen to them.
Right.
Because they know how to sing for real.
Right.
So I remember listening to We Belong Together. It's like that. I was in the basement with my friend. I was singing. And he was looking at me, and I thought he was going to try to play me or something because I didn't know.
Okay.
He was like, you sound pretty good. I was like, who? He was like, you. I was like, really? So I didn't know at the time, but I knew when you in the bathroom, there's like a loudness. I didn't know it was called acoustic at the time.
Right.
But something told me to go in there to like confirm.
Mm-hmm.
And I did. And it felt really good. And I was like,
yeah,
I think I'd still want to act, but I think I want to do this first.
Okay.
And from there, I didn't even know I was a songwriter. I started writing music. And the first song I wrote was something uplifting.
Okay.
I was like 15 and all in my bag talking about some. I think one of the first songs was called Go Get A, Go Get A, Go Get A. And I was just like, oh, okay, cool. So from then I started writing music and I started like performing everywhere they would let me perform, like literally everywhere. I started going to the studio. I was getting stuff off of like.
Now let me slow you down just a second because I got to jump in because I'm getting in trance.
Right.
I love the whole movie.
You told me.
I love the movie.
You're doing a great job.
You started performing, so I gotta ask the questions. Where were you performing? When you say everywhere, let them know everywhere that you were performing, because I know what it's like for up and coming artists and when you want to.
I was performing at Girard Avenue a lot, Arts Garage, the
Arts
Fire
Garage.
Philly.
There you go, the Fire.
I have old footage too. If y'all don't believe me, it's all on my YouTube, and I left it on there on purpose. There's sometimes I still go back and watch from 10 years ago, and I'm just like, that's crazy.
Now let them know where they can find you at.
Find me, Slay Myas, on all platforms.
There you go, baby.
YouTube, Slay Myas, SLAYMAYAS. That's where you can find all my music videos, content from years ago when I was performing, when I even had a mohawk and I had blonde hair.
Mohawk with the blonde.
Never again will we do that.
Okay.
But
you were going through something at that particular.
Oh, yeah, growing.
No doubt.
It was a lot.
You were growing. The butterfly, you were blossoming.
You can find me on Instagram as well, Slay Myers. I'm pretty active on there and open on there, so you can find me there as well. But yeah, I was performing everywhere. Gerard Avenue, the Fire, Philly.
Even did you like go back to New York and do any open mics or any shows?
Yeah, I did that. I even was doing birthday parties, like singing happy birthday to people.
Yeah, my singing one, telegrams.
Yeah, even like Christmas, like going door to door and doing like little like Christmas songs or whatever. Mm-hmm. I had my one friend at the time, my really tight friend at the time. He was like low key my manager. Mm-hmm. He heard me sing. I met him through one of my friends. He heard me sing and he was like, I don't know nothing about this music ish, but I want to help you. And he legit was like my brother and my friend for years. And he used to like take me to birthday parties. This is my artist, Slay. Right. And she about to sing happy birthday. We have memories of all that. My Google Drive memories be coming up sometimes and I be cracking up like, wow. This is all the stuff we used to do. That's crazy.
So, I mean, so you got to be able to blow. I mean, being able to be called on the spot, which you should be able to do.
Yeah.
Right? When you're saying you're taking yourself seriously as a singer.
Yeah.
But being able to sing on the spot in front of people at the drop of a dime.
Yeah.
So you know you're confident. I can sing.
Yeah.
No doubt. Yeah. I mean, I'm looking forward to it. You get what I'm saying? Aside from hearing it, you know, from an audio standpoint, I would love to hear it live. I love live music. I
Me
love
too.
Live performances.
That's why I love acoustics.
Yes.
That's why I love, I grew up with the MTV Unplugged. That's what I was thinking about when I was doing this. That's why
we're
I love
gonna
acoustics.
We're going to be friends for a long time because I have a lot of great ideas and that's the vibe that I want to go with. You feel what I'm saying? And I feel that you would fit perfectly into that. So you'll definitely be hearing more from CEO Row in the near future. You dig what I'm saying? I like the whole acoustic vibe. The band.
And just so y'all know, Confessional, I dropped already back in May. There's a video for it. It's just a regular version, normal production, everything. I decided to do an acoustic version, the one that's coming out now, because I just felt like stripping it down and singing it differently.
I give you a round of applause for that.
So I just want y'all to know that.
Again, artistically, that's awesome. I mean, a lot of people aren't thinking to do that in crossover. They're thinking to do it one way. Not thinking, okay, I can do it this way and possibly this way as well. You feel me? Because a lot of people are afraid to step out of their box, especially as an artist.
I'm glad you confirmed that because I started thinking maybe I'm doing too much. Mm-hmm. But I was like, no, you're good. So thank you.
No doubt. You know, we could call it remixes.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, you know, again, that's really dope. I want to know, what inspired Slay Myers to be, you already started, what inspired you to become an artist? You told us when, but what really inspired you to say, I want to be an artist?
You know what's crazy? I would say, I guess once I discovered I could sing and I started like obsessively listening to like the divas, Mariah Carey, Whitney Houston, Christina Aguilera, Kelly Clarkson, Fantasia, you know, right. I was just...
Good names, I had all great names.
I used to I went through like four stereos because I had a cat that kept dropping them on the floor.
Okay.
And I was just like studying. But I think I kind of just fell into it naturally because like I said, I've always been like a feeler. Mm-hmm. People usually couldn't tell, but I've always been like one of those like, even if I don't say nothing, it's inside like, that made me mad. I'm right about that.
Oh shit, okay, I feel
Piss
that.
Me
I
understand. Off. Or
you had a journal or a diary at a very young age.
Yeah, okay. Or something inspiring, or I'll watch like a documentary or something, I just learn about life or something, or another level, or like manifestation. I'm just like, and I start thinking about magic, and I'm like, just say everything that you think is magical on the paper. Right. It's a process too. When I don't know about anybody else, but I feel like probably people do go through this.
Right.
When I like write music, it's such a process. Not like getting to the point where I'm like, I feel comfortable with what's happening here.
Right.
Yeah. It's first, I hear this, what I like, and I'm going through the motions, and I'm like, oh, you suck. That's too much. That's whack. Mm-hmm. That sounds too much like what you did last time. Mm-hmm. Or whatever thing comes to my artist brain, you know,
right.
The artist mind.
Right.
And then
it never stops.
You get to that point where it's like, oh, I think we got some here. Right. That's the sweet spot. But I think... when I discovered it was
right
at that time.
Yes, ma'am.
Right at that time.
There we go. Mm-hmm.
And like I said, I've always been, I don't know, just how I'm talking now, that's how I would talk to someone in the street about life. And when I'm discovering things about life, it's so exciting.
It came naturally.
Oh my God, yeah.
Not forced.
Yeah.
Right.
Almost, I always say, I think there's a gospel singer in me somewhere. Somewhere, deep down inside. Because it's like, soul, I feel, I want you to feel too.
Okay.
You know,
No doubt. That's real dope. I want to know, what is also the inspiration behind the name Slay Myas? How did you become Slay Myas?
Back to my friend again. Okay. Shout out to Skeezy. Good Deed Skeez.
Oh, shit. Good Deed Skeezy. Shouts out to you.
That's how he talks.
Okay.
He's a Libra, and he's hilarious.
Okay.
He was like, I got off the stage one time. He was like, goddamn, Slay. Okay. Slay Myas. Myas is my surname. He was like, Slay Myas. And I was like, I think I like the sound of that, because it kind of is like, you know, that's me. Sweet, spicy, and I come to slay. So I was like, I like that.
Slay Myas. I think that's a real dope name, too. We just wanted to clarify, you know, how that came about, because I think it's a dope name as well. You feel me? So that came from the manager slash friend who just really coined it. After
he was like, God damn, Slay Myas.
I guess it's Slay.
He was like, God damn, Slay. I was like, all right. And he had the little sword emoji. It was crazy. It was so funny, but that's how the name came about.
Well, I wanted to get into, you know, some of your musical influences, but I see that you've already named quite a few. Mariah Carey, Fantasia, Jessica Simpson. Did I hear that?
She was part of the, I guess, because I was playing her like crazy. That one song, A Little Bit Goes a Long Way, I was stuck on that for a while.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. And that's the beautiful thing. And I know you understand that. That's going to lead into my next question, but you never know how far your music reaches and who your music touches.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? As an artist, you might say, okay, well, I make my music for maybe this demographic.
Right.
Not saying you per se, but just as an artist in general, like I'm making my music for these people. But you never know who it may touch outside of that demographic, who it may reach outside of that demographic. You dig what I'm saying? It's My Time has reached, according to Spotify, over 3,600 streams.
Man.
You dig what I'm saying? Your music has reached at least 61 countries.
Jeez.
And this is all info, you know, from data from Spotify. You dig what I'm saying?
Right.
So I want to know, like, how do you feel your music's being received out here?
I feel really good, because I remember when I was first starting out, I tell the story just like everybody else starting out in the business. You find out you can do this thing called music and you sing it, and you just like, okay, I want to sing, I want to do this, and you're not even focused on like the whole like business aspect. You just like, I just want to do this, I want to have fun, I want to just be an artist, I want to create, I don't care about all that book stuff and nerd stuff, I don't care.
Paperwork.
And then it keeps creeping up on you, you got scammed again, keeps creeping up on you, you're not learning the business, and you're getting blocked here again because you don't know. So. It feels very good, because it was quite a journey to get to the, and I still don't feel like I'm at where I want to be at completely, but compared to like where I used to be, I'm like, yeah, people are actually listening. People DM you and tell you, you know, what the music did, or Artistic Butterfly, they get the vibe.
Or maybe how it has inspired or motivated them in some type of way.
Yeah.
How it may have gotten them over a trial or tribulation in life. You dig what I'm saying? Maybe they found themselves again to one of your songs.
Who knows? Yeah.
Maybe they found love. Who knows?
Yeah.
You dig me? It's so many ranges, depending on your mood and how you will display that or express that through your music.
And how they interpret it. So, yeah, I mean, it just feels really good. And I'm just excited to, like, I always remind myself, like, keep going. Because I be having, like, real conversations with myself. I'm not, like, delusional. I'm like, oh, I'm just going to do this, and I'm perfect, and I don't have anything to work on. I'm just like, yeah, you got something. Just stay, like, consistent. I feel like if I would have been this, like, I guess smart when I was younger, but I guess that all comes with wisdom and trial and error. I'm like, yeah, you would have had a Grammy by now, but you know what? You going to get it. It's just gonna be later, because you know what? You would have messed it up, because you was crazy. You would have messed it up, all right? So,
No doubt.
Yeah.
I understand. Like, that's the thing of being youthful. We're so quick to just want to jump out there and make it happen.
Yeah.
We're not really looking like what all goes into play to make it happen.
It's like a baby.
Yeah.
You know, when you're pregnant for 9 months, you're not just going to be pregnant for 3-4. Oh, here's the baby. Right. It's not going to be good.
It's not going to be
good. You got to wait.
It takes preparation.
You got to let that joint develop.
No doubt. But listen, I'm definitely enjoying this interview. You're Yay. Definitely a dope individual.
Yay.
I appreciate you coming again on the CEO Role Experience and kicking it with us. We have to go on our first break, of course. But before we do that, let the people know where they can find you at.
So Slay Myers, you can find me. I'm Slay Myers on all platforms, by the way. It's not like I'm Slay Myers and somebody else. Slay Myers on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, Spotify, Threads now. I just join it all to give everybody, just spread out as much as possible. But YouTube, all of that. Slay Myers, S-L-A-Y-M-A-Y-A-S. Tune in.
I can dig it. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back with more of the CEO Role Experience and my special guest, Slay Myers.
Hey, Slay Hamama.
Niggas ain't all that they seen. Nigga, you calling a team. Thinking it all just a dream. Ready, don't y'all intervene. Figure the boss is supreme. All this is part of my scheme. Nigga, a star on the screen. Off of the cream. Now take a walk in the steam. We talking regime. Hawking the beam. Beef to my dog is cuisine. Look what I took and I gave. Put in the grave. If you don't look to behave, what if they say? Hey, you better look to be brave. Hey, you pay. Look at the rep. Nigga, that's quiet as kept. Failure that I ain't accept. If you don't like it, to step. Thinking, no, really, like, why have you slept? Now that I've crept. Picturing. Me and you different. It ain't no arguing. It ain't no bickering. Fuck all the laughing and fuck all the giggling. Change all the subject when bullets is whistling. Stop all the fidgeting. Holly, your body just shaking and shivering. Now what the fuck is you listening? Fuck is you figuring? This total package is what I'm delivering.
What it be? 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 Is it them?
Is it them?
Is it me?
Or is it me?
Lock it down.
Lock it down.
It's the key.
It's the key.
Check my eyes.
Check my eyes.
What you see?
What you see? Now what
it be?
What it be?
What it be?
What it be?
Is it them?
Is it them?
Is it me?
Or is it me?
Lock it down.
Lock it down.
It's the key.
That's the key.
Check my eyes.
Check my eyes.
What you see?
Now what you see? Now what you see?
Suckers through these Cartiers. That what I see.
That what I see.
I'ma down a nigga fast. That what it be.
That what it be.
I was known for getting cash. Them racks on me.
Them racks on
40
me.
40 cal with that stick. That's on me.
That's on
I was never known for no lacking. I was never known for no capping. I was always known for the action.
Lay him down now.
Yeah, yeah. War so special to me. I keep metal with me. Cognac in my body in that ghetto with me. Yeah, fuck up a check. Fuck up a check.
I was broke.
So I burned my connect. Burned my connect. That's on four. Brand new race.
Moon on the tag.
You play games, we on your ass. You down for 4.5,
yeah.
When you look at me, what you see is a G. And a nigga that could turn 9 into a key. My man got caught lacking, they threw 9 in his V. I was supposed to buy the wheel, that was supposed to be me.
Would it be?
Would it be?
Would it be?
Would it be?
Is it them?
Is it them?
Is it me?
Is it me?
Lock it down.
Lock it down.
It's the key.
This the key.
Check my eyes.
Check my eyes.
What you see?
What you see?
Would it be?
Would it be?
Would it be?
Would it be?
Is it them?
Is it them?
Is it me?
Is it me?
Lock it down.
Lock it down.
This the key.
This the key.
Check my eyes.
Check my eyes.
What you see?
What you see?
You know what? You know what? I'm not the one that wanted that break, okay? You're the one that bailed on this. You're the one that ran the moment things got just a little rough.
That's
what?
That is neither here nor there.
Okay, well, here we are. Now we're in a tough spot again, Rich. What do you want to do? How do you want to handle it, huh? Do you want to fight for us, or do you want to bail?
Big Jeezy got it. I am so proud of a lot of things that I did. It's hard to smile. Been thinking about calling it quits. I need to slow down. I need to slow down. I need to slow down. slow down. I need to slow down. I ain't too proud of a lot of things that I did. It's hard to smile, to smile. Been thinking about calling it quits. I need to slow down. I ain't too proud, don't know what to do now. Try to be quiet about it, I ain't too loud. Hope it was all lies, seem like it's true now. Can't get a ring by myself, I need you round. So tell me, is you down? Never can hate you or being grateful. Like you ain't built me up, how could I break you? Somehow you got away still, like I ain't chase you. Or I let you drown in it, cause I couldn't save you. I was unable, couldn't swallow my pride for you. I would've killed for you, and I would've died for you. I would've changed my life, I even tried for you. Ain't even know I had emotions, but I cried for you. You lie for you just to make the fantasy last. Husband and dad, you destroyed my plans to be that. I am no longer myself, I need my sanity back. I'm alone, barely can sleep, I need my family back.
So proud of a lot of things that I did. It's hard to smile, so smile. Been thinking about calling it quits. I need to slow down.
I need to slow down, stop having these hoes round. The niggas that's too joke, you calling me bro now. Drop my guard, you probably think I'm a joke now. Stop acting like an amateur, that's cause I'm a pro now. Which way do I go now? I'm lost in emotions, drowning in sorrow, got lost in your ocean. My heart is broken, and your heart is broken. But never throw salt in the wounds when it's open. I thought it was a nightmare until I woke up. It's too late to fix now, it's always broke up. Getting pushed back down when I had my hopes up. Is you kidding me? I thought we could talk like grown-ups. Stop hanging the phone up and listen a few now. No, my screws ain't tight, I'm probably missing a few now. You too far, I want the distance removed now. Gotta admit it, cause I just wanna see you smile. And I ain't too proud
of a lot of things that I did. It's hard to smile, so smile. Been thinking about calling it quits. I need to slow down. I need to slow down. So proud of a lot of things that I did. It's hard to smile, so smile. Been thinking about calling it quits. I need to slow down.
Energy, you are not what you pretend to be. Negative vibes, what you send to me. They try to treat me like Kennedy, yeah. Feeling real big like it's 10 to me, yeah. You were the one that keep telling me, yeah. Feeling my swag, she smelling me, yeah. All in my bag, I'm digging up.
Now I lay myself down to sleep. I pray the Lord keep the hater 6 feet.
We gon' lay 6 feet by the end of this week. I'll never lose sleep. I ain't never been sweet. I ain't never been weak. I ain't never been cheap. I'll spin this street like.
Pull up, hop out, what's up, shut up. Hop out, what's up, shut up. Pull up, hop out, what's up, shut up. Pull up, hop out, what's up, shut up.
Energy, yeah. You are not friend, you are enemy, yeah. You cannot take what is meant for me, yeah. Totally ready, you kidding me, yeah. See in the bag, I'm getting it, yeah. They in the bag, and that's where they stay. Going too fast, but I will not break. All of my bag, but I will not break. See that you mad, you better just pray. If you not hunter, then you are to prey. Gotta be hungry or you gon' get ate. Yeah, open your eyes and you can relate. I done seen vibes turning the skates. Always on gold, you were just fake. If you don't know, then you in a way.
Pull up, hop out, what's up, shut up. Pull up, hop out, what's up, shut up. Pull up, hop out, what's up, shut up. Pull up, hop out, what's up, shut up.
You can't top, you can't pop, you can't rock, you can't stop, you can't make, you can't fake, you can't take my energy, ayy. You can't top, you can't pop, you can't rock, you can't stop, you can't make, you can't fake, you can't take my energy, eh?
ABR energy, energy, ABR energy, energy, ABR energy, energy, ABR energy, energy,
And we're back with the major vibes. You know what I'm saying? On the CEO Row Experience, man. You're now rocking with the best. Come and get this experience in the flesh. And tonight, man, we have the lovely Slay Myers in the building. She brought the vibes. You already know. We sipping on the Slay Hama Mama. You dig what I'm saying?
This is a really good drink, by the way.
Yes, it is.
Slay and Hama it's slow Mama. Dripping.
Slow dripping. You've been saying that a lot. That's your shit right there. Slow dripping.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But let's go ahead and get back into this interview, babe, because I'm sure it's other people that want to get in your business like me.
Oh, man. Let's go there. Do we dare?
Now, we were talking about you being a singer.
Yes.
And how enthused you were about being a singer once you learned that you could actually sing.
Yeah.
Any vocal training?
No.
Like, what do we do to warm the chords up?
I told you, my vocal teachers was Mariah, Whitney. I just listened to what they said or what they were doing.
Right.
It was a lot of rewinding. It was a lot of late nights. It was a lot of my mom telling me to turn the radio down because they're going to think we have something expensive and break in or something.
Oh, shit.
My mom's Haitian, so she's very dramatic. In the house.
Yeah.
So I never really had, I did choir when I was in high school, and it's so funny, when I look at my report cards now, that's one of the classes I did like A++ in. Everything else was like, girl, I don't know. But I never really went to like a vocal teacher.
Right.
I feel like it was there the whole time, I just didn't know.
It just was natural.
It was just there, I just learned later.
Right, copy.
Yeah.
And then you just picked up on it by hearing other singers. And the pitches.
Yeah, it was a lot of pausing and like listening to where it came from. And I'm like, that sounds like she's coming from her nose. It sounds like she's like breathing from her belly, maybe. I don't know. But
you got to sing the song, Anime. You got to hit it from here. He said from the guts, like. You
from the
hit
diaphragm.
It from the gut. Yeah, from the diaphragm. You got to sing it.
Anime.
Sing this motherfucking song.
Yeah, he taught her from the fram.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what does Slay Myers like to do when she's relaxing? Like when you're not doing music and when you're not trying to create and you just want to take a break for a moment?
Do I want to tell y'all what I be doing?
This is what we here for.
I watch a lot of like true crime. I don't know if that says a lot about me or not. I was a little hesitant to say that, but
no.
I watch a lot of, sometimes it's not even me watching, it's just background noise. Girl, I don't know what that means. But I really be getting into it. Sometimes it gets a little intense when it's like, when they start getting into the kiss, I'm like, yeah, that's too much. But I really enjoy true crime.
True crime.
Like First 48.
Yeah.
Snap.
Forensic Files.
I like For My Man.
Oh, you like those.
These people are crazy.
With the storyline drama shit that goes with it.
What's the most recent one? I've been watching Black Girl Gone.
Okay.
Yeah, about like crimes that happened to like black girls that went missing and didn't really get any like
exposure or attention for it.
And you listen to some of these stories and it's like, damn, this is really crazy. But I really enjoy that.
I understand that. Because it's like informative. It lets me know what's going on in the world, what things I should keep my eye out for when I am out in the world, traveling, shit like that. Because in my mind, when I'm watching the Slay, I feel like, damn, I don't really see that shit. I know it goes on. Don't get me wrong. Like, I know it goes on. But on my day-to-day try, like, I don't see that.
Right.
So let me be mindful that this is what's going on out here.
Don't be naive.
Yeah, don't be naive to, you know.
The people in those situations, they never thought that either. That's what I always think about. I'm like, damn, she opened the door. She didn't even know. And it's little things like that. You think, like, wow. She didn't even know she was opening the door.
And I like that you brought that point up, sis, because you're not weird or you're not a bitch or you're not a coward for taking the necessary precautions that's going to keep you alive.
Yeah.
Some people move through like, I don't give a fuck. If it's meant to be, it'll happen.
Yeah, I don't know.
But at the end of the day, you need to take precautions.
Yeah.
You feel me? Meaning like, no, I'm not opening that door. Who the fuck is it?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm not going to just be willing to
open. Who just opens
door.
Doors anymore nowadays anyways?
Right.
Like, people just knock. Who does that? Like, what? Yeah.
Back in my day, like, if you're on my block too long and I know all the cars that's on my block, I literally know who has every car that's on the block.
Yeah.
If your car is on my block for too long and there's somebody in it, I'm coming to it.
Man. And sometimes I feel like I gotta take a step back, because sometimes that joint really be, I'm like, yeah, you gotta chill, because now you're starting to think weird. Like, when, you gotta slow down.
When does it become weird, Slay? See, when does it become weird? Like, it's a form of security. Like, meaning I'm thinking this way or I'm carrying it this way for security purposes only.
Okay, it gets to that point where, because again, we would, like we were just talking, self-control is big.
Right.
Like, when you can really, like, sit there and, like, even if you're thinking something,
right.
if you just, like, hold on.
Right.
Just give it a few more minutes because correct. You know you're a little dramatic.
Correct.
To see the outcome, because you're giving yourself all these different narratives and you're believing and you're going with it. Let's just wait and see.
You're emotional.
You're emotional.
The feelings are running high, so you're going to believe what it is that you're saying, your brain is saying, you know, saying. You're going to feel it, your emotions.
Especially if you've been through stuff before and you got to just like, all right.
Of course.
This looks like what I've seen before. And then when you get to the end and it was like, it's not what you thought. It's like, damn, I really went out there. All right, bring it back. Bring it back a little bit. But
just don't ever go too far unless you're willing, you know, you're really willing to go too far.
Yeah. I like that. I like cooking. I'm a dog person. I don't have kids or anything.
I was going to ask that. Are you an animal lover? You look like an animal lover. Let me guess. More dogs than cats?
Yes. I have.
You have, let me guess. You look like a person that has about two dogs.
Yeah.
And a cat.
I have two dogs. I would love a cat, but cats are too much work.
Okay.
You got to clean that litter box.
You have just two dogs.
On a daily. I don't have the time. I'm an artist. It's just too much work. I take the dogs outside and it's like, good to go.
Dogs messy as shit, Slay. But I mean, cool. If they house dogs, they might not be messy as shit.
Oh my God.
I don't know how you carry it with the dogs.
I have a dog that's 13. Then I have one that's like 1 year and 4 months.
Okay.
So.
They're your babies.
Yeah. I feel like those are my practice babies before my babies.
Oh, shit. You talk to them?
Yeah. I'm not even going to tell you what I be saying because it sound crazy. We're going to keep that on the low.
They hear all that shit. Yeah.
I have special voices for them and everything. But
wow. You talk, you whisper to them. You are a dog whisperer.
Yes. And I feel like animals, they smart. They understand stuff. They They know when people actually vibe with them and they understand, like, when you love them and they have love for you too. Like, they totally understand that.
They get it. Well, it's their nature, and you have to understand they're not human, so they don't, that instinct, they don't have that. It's natural. It's just like, it's what's in me. They go with it.
Right.
They not, you know what I'm saying? It's, I don't really think they think too much unless it's how to, you know, execute whatever the plan is. But they don't have that instinct. They just do. They react. Like, meaning if they're meant to kill shit, they're going to kill shit.
Yeah.
It's not like they have to. You have to groom them to do it.
It's just in
them. Right. That's what I'm saying.
It's already there.
Copy.
So I enjoy, like, I like peaceful stuff. Like, I could see myself living on a farm later on.
Okay.
I like quiet. I like to just, like, when I'm off, I just like to be at the house and just doing home things.
So do you like the sweet southern tea on the porch in the rocking chair?
Yes.
Yeah.
Nice weather.
Okay.
Nice big house and a lot of land, animals. I just like chill stuff.
Yeah, you seem like you like, I'm getting that vibe, bro.
Yeah.
You know,
I like to clean.
Okay.
Regular shit. I like to go to grocery shopping.
Okay.
I like that stuff. Okay. Going to Lowe's and like looking at house stuff. I'm like, all right.
You like to do laundry and full clothes.
It excites me.
Okay. That's what I'm saying. You seem like interior decorating. Yeah. Oh, like, oh, let's rearrange this over here. I just have a vision.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I like all that.
Yeah.
All that.
I'm getting these vibes. These vibes are coming in strong on the CEO row.
It's
coming in strong. I get it. I really get it. Real dope though. I like, if I can get it, that's dope. If I don't get
that
it,
that means it's real.
Bingo.
No fakes over here, man.
No, that's, we don't want that. That's the whole, you can't come and get the experience being fake. You know what I'm saying?
And I don't, I'm like,
you can't come be yourself, be real, so you can truly get the full effect of the experience.
Connect with the people.
And on that, I'm going to sip on some of my Slay Hama Mama.
Yes, sir.
So this is going good. I know you ain't going hard because you have to sing at the end of this.
Yeah, I don't usually do this, but I'm having a good time today. Mm-hmm. Why not?
Mm. Why not? It is very delicious. Very delicious. you know, we all have dreams and aspirations, Slay. I want to know, what are your dreams and aspirations? What is Slay doing all this for, and where does Slay want to see this you know, take her at the end of the day?
I'm doing all this to be on my farm.
Mm-hmm.
No cameras today, please. No cameras today, please. Be on the live. I'm cooking something today. I got right. my Grammys up here.
Right.
I always had this feeling. I don't have kids yet.
Right.
I feel like I'll be like a 40-year-old mom. I don't know. I feel like that's going to happen. But I feel like I'm going to have twins.
Well, I'm a 40-year-old single dad. And, like, literally, like, when I say single, like, yeah, I take care of shit. Like, yeah, I'm single. I have, I'm not going to say it like this.
Okay. You have a village?
Because I love my women.
Okay.
Real rap. I have help. Shouts out to Cherie Griffin. And shouts out to my mother.
Hey, shout out to moms.
You know, Mama Flora, she, you know, she helps when she can. I don't push, but see, this is again, and I know this because we come from a black family. I know when I say that, people understand. I don't tend to push my responsibility of my kids off onto anyone. So just the same way how you would feel as being a black mother, I carry that on as well as being a black father.
Right. Pride.
Like, even though, yeah, I know you're there, right? Like, I know you're there, and I know you fuck with me and my kids, right? But I'm not about to call you like, yo, you want to come get them? I'm not that person.
Like,
I'm,
I don't know what to do with them today. Come get them.
Yeah, I always know what to fucking do with them. You know what I mean? And I got boys. So, you know, I always know what to do with them. But, you know, yeah, shouts out to my support system. It's not
always
very
shout out to the support
system.
Strong. That's all you need. That's all you need. A steady foundation. That's all you need.
I love my women. They keep me grounded.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I try to keep myself. They keep me grounded. Shouts out to them. But, yeah.
I'm doing all this to be on the farm.
Yes, babe.
I'm doing all this to show, because it took me some time to get to that confidence point. Mm-hmm. I feel like we all go through things in life in the beginning where we're trying to find ourselves.
Right.
I'm doing this for the underdog to show you, see?
There you go.
You thought you were a loser, but it turns out you were the gem the whole time.
Mm.
I told you. Now get your Grammy and go home and drink.
Can I speak on that? A lot of people feel like they're not recognized. And they know that they're a gem. See, that's a hard role to play, too, to be in a situation knowing that you're the gem. You dig what I'm saying? That you're really a strong piece in a situation, and then you have to play a back seat, and you have to wait until it's the right time to shine.
Well, this is what Uptown Wiz said a few minutes ago.
Shouts out to Uptown Wizard.
Your circle is big, and we just was talking about that, how, like, sometimes you don't even know it. And I feel like when you do have that energy, other people see it before you sometimes.
That's real.
And that's why I'm always telling people, oh, well, you should have known that for yourself.
Right.
Some people don't want you to know that.
That's,
some people want you to think that you not nothing.
That's real.
You should have learned that.
That's a real dope gem that you just dropped, because that's the thing. That's why you have to believe in yourself. Because there's a lot of people that don't want you to recognize the opportunity.
That's why they try to break
you down.
Some
people can't stop it from coming because you are just who you are. The energy's good, the things are gravitating, but they don't want you to recognize that you have it so that you could take advantage of it and really shoot off.
Mm-hmm.
You dig what I'm saying?
So that's why they always say how kids, the childhood means a lot. Mm-hmm. If people break your spirit early, it takes work to build that back up, because you look at yourself in the mirror and you just like, there's nothing wrong with me.
Right.
No, it's like your brain, you gotta flip it. You gotta learn something different. You gotta clean the slate.
And I think that you're on your way to being an awesome mother one day. I
began emotional about that.
Just keep the focus of what you have there, and it'll work, because that was real dope.
Yeah.
You know, the thing is, when they're kids, is to uplift their spirits. Don't break their spirits. Because once you, when you incorporate that and you make it strong, that's when they can go out and understand, I can be whoever the fuck I want to be.
Yeah. And
you
it's
I mean?
Work. Even some parents, that's why even me as myself, I'm like glad I'll probably be an old parent, because I'm like, when you really think about some of our backgrounds, it's like, I did not have them tools. If I was somebody's mama early, I don't know. I would have tried my best, but I probably would have failed miserably. And that's a terrible job to do.
Well, let me just say this, and I don't want you to count yourself out so short. There's a lot of people that did not expect to have kids and thought that they couldn't do it. I for one, and I'm gonna be honest, I'm gonna share this with you, I didn't have kids for a long time. No, I could have them. I could have them, but I didn't have them because I felt the same way.
You were scared.
But I'm an awesome motherfucker. Why would I not want to share that with a child? You know what I mean? Or incorporate that into one of my kids.
Yeah.
Like, why be afraid of that? That's who I am. That's my legacy. But then again, I did understand that I wanted to be there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I didn't want to be one that was running around or building what I have and
have
not
some
have
sort
enough
of
time.
Family stability.
Exactly. Have a foundation.
Yeah.
You feel what I'm saying?
That's super important.
Yeah, but I really feel like, you know, you can, if you, so it's a lot of times that shit's forced on you. If you didn't plan it, and I don't think a lot of us do, you feel me?
You're going to learn today.
Yeah, you're going to, exactly.
You're going to learn today.
That's the affirmation for that. Like, you're going to learn today.
You're going to learn today.
You're either going to get with the motherfucking program or you're not.
You're going to learn today because you don't got no choice. It's there.
And I really feel like a lot of people don't want to be looked at as a bad parent. Some motherfuckers, man, we know it's just some fucked up motherfuckers out there. And I just say this because this pertains to every entity or every situation that you enter, not just being a parent. You know what I mean? You definitely have to, you know, believe in yourself, like we said in the beginning, and you have to know that you're going to see this through. But yeah, we also know there's just some rotten, no good motherfuckers out there.
Oh, I told you, I'll be watching those true crimes. Some people be, I'm like, oh yeah, let's stop, because that's a little too much.
Real quick.
The babies, oh my God, no.
Real quick, woke up this morning, seen a drink, you know, my beautiful significant other came in and was just like, yo, did you see this? Because, you know, my phone is the newspaper now when I go to the bathroom.
Oh, yeah.
So now I'm on there looking at all the current events.
Mm-hmm.
So is this fucking young boy, man, I forget where he's at. He raped his teacher and killed her.
Okay.
Because he didn't like teachers, he says.
And how old was he?
Allegedly raped his teacher.
Allegedly? She's dead?
And I think he killed her, too. If I'm not mistaken, he raped and killed her as well.
Okay.
And said that he doesn't like tea. Like, what the fuck is going on with people?
I don't know. He might be watching a little too much true crime for his young mind.
That's crazy. Like, what if my wife, but I'm just saying, what if my beautiful wife? Slay, that's crazy. I caught the watching too much true crime.
Yeah, he might be starting a little too early. Your brain's still developing.
What if my beautiful wife is at school and she cares about the kids? She loves the kids, Slay.
And you think about her.
And then one of these rotten motherfuckers take her from me. Oh, I don't think I will ever be the same. I don't know how I would handle that personally. I don't know how that would take a toll on me for the remainder of my days.
I don't know either, man. And nobody can blame you for how you act, because that's a lot.
That's a lot,
right? That's a lot.
It's a lot going on out here. Protect our women, you know what I'm saying? And first and foremost, protect your motherfucking self. That's first and foremost. I don't give a fuck if you a girl or a boy, a man or a woman. Protect yourself first, because there's a lot going on out here. You feel what I'm saying? There's a lot.
It's an understatement. A lot.
No doubt. So, you know, stay guarded, stay prayed.
That's why you make music for the good vibes, so you can escape all that craziness.
There you go.
Think
about
a
little Slay Myers in your life,
man.
Yeah, you know I mean, vibe especially
high.
That new acoustic version. You know what I'm saying? Of hold up, you gotta help me, Slay. Don't help me. Confessionals. Acoustic,
you know,
version
vibe
of confessionals.
High. Think about that farm
high
and
vibes.
The Grammys on the mantle.
There you go.
Waking up and having
that
a slow morning.
Is dope. I can see you could come and put your hat on, got your little tank top and jeans on, your little Wranglers.
I only go to the store for the basic stuff, and they'd be like, Slay, I'm like, no cameras today, please.
Oh, shit.
I'm thinking, you know Sade?
Yeah, I love Sade.
Kind of like
know
that.
I love Sade. Don't play with
reclusive,
girl.
Like, I come out when I feel like it, come on the carpet when I feel like it, and disappear when I feel
you
like it.
You know who else is like that? Anita Baker.
Come on, Anita.
The reason why I'm saying, because she was one of the divas growing up, you know, that we listened to.
Mm-hmm.
You never noticed that she just, like, she's reclusive. She doesn't come out to a lot of shit even back then, and she's not out there a lot. You
think she come out when she feel like it.
Exactly. You know, you have to be a little exclusive.
So, overall, we are doing this
to
slow down. Okay. You know, I'm just here to do what God told me to do and just do my dream and fulfill the promise to myself, because this is a self thing. It's like, I told you could do this. Like,
oh,
you thought
shit.
You were back.
I heard that.
I told you. Yeah. You got a Grammy.
That's
I told
what you,
you.
Be saying
and it's
to yourself.
Unbelievable.
And
I
the
told
dogs.
You.
You be saying that to yourself and the dogs.
Listen,
the dogs,
you want to know so bad what I say to these dogs.
I know that's a fly on the wall type of thing right there.
It's all love, though. They're the babies.
No doubt.
My practice babies.
No doubt.
Shout out to Chubby and Batista.
There you go. Chubby and Batista.
We love them. Oh, my God. Yeah. I'm getting shy.
I want to know, before we end this second segment, I want to know, are there any other talents or gifts you would like to share with us, Slay?
Oh, my gosh. There's many.
Yeah. Share some of it. It seems like you're a woman of many talents.
Well, y'all know I can sing.
Yes, we know you
y'all
can sing.
Y'all know I can sing.
Oh, shit.
I'm a good cook.
What do you
I can
prefer
cook really,
to cook?
Really good.
But what do you prefer?
I'm always thinking about, like, I be trying to cook for like flavor and health at the same time. So I'm always, my meals always include greens, vegetables, some type of salad.
Okay.
I always cook with olive oil.
Okay.
I've been cooking with butter for the last week, but I've been feeling myself, but I'll stop. Because, okay, you know, I was just having fun.
Yeah. I'm feeling myself.
Keep my heart good, you know? But I love to cook. Another talent. I speak another language. I'm Haitian, so I speak Creole.
Oh, okay.
You probably don't know language, you know?
No, I don't know. But let me know.
What do you want me to tell you in Creole?
The CEO roast experience is the dopest experience that I've had all year.
Okay, so lem vini sou show sa CEO roast experience se pi bon program me vini pou tout ane. Pi bon program vini pou tout ane.
Pi bon. Pi bon.
Better, that's what that means.
Better.
Way better.
You know, way better. I like that. Way better.
Yeah, way better.
No doubt. I caught that part of it.
You know what? I took piano for about a year when I was 19. And
I'm going to do that. That's on my bucket list before
I'm gonna
I die.
I'm going to start again.
I'm going to learn how to play the piano.
Yeah.
That's a fact.
There's so many. And it's random stuff. But I guess those are the ones I guess I should talk about.
No doubt. No doubt. And that's good. You know, again, a little bit more insight into Slay Myers is always a great thing.
I love it. I want people to know, because I know when I'm looking into artists that I like, I be newsy.
Right.
So I'm sure people want to know. So I'd be like, ooh, what?
Facts. I'm glad that you said that.
It's
but before
real.
We go to this commercial segment, Slay, please let the people know where they can find you at.
Slay Myers. You can find me on all platforms, Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, Threads, Spotify, Apple Music, SLAYMAYAS, all over. Prepare for the good vibes. Don't say I didn't warn you.
Always good vibes,
prepare
man.
To vibe high.
You already know. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back with more of the CEO Raw Experience and more of my special guest, Slay Myers, and these Slay Hama Mamas, baby.
Cheers. Obiga.
They mad, broke, that's the issue. Okay. When I grab the fresh slate, got to grab the pistol, hit him, spin back with bullets the size of missiles, hit him, bones break, bullets rip through tissue. We ain't talking money, gross the most in the fiscal. Make the hardest rapper out feel like he had a mission. Loaded, cock it, fire. Then reload it again. Loaded, cock it, fire. Then reload it again. Loaded, cock it, fire. Then reload it again. Load it, cock it, fire. Then reload it again.
I bought some more ammunition, right?
Y'all. Then reload it again.
Son.
They talk money, but you never see they finance. Why they decline and we all stepping like a line dance. Made men, affiliated, we tied in. Dollars paid the way they throw up them diamonds. The clip hit you like an elbow from the top rope. Instagram hater, they be trolling on my top post. You not low, we are hiding the streets, but on beat. I pop tracks, HDE, I'm out of reach. Gangsta rapper shaking that, don't discriminate. You just eliminate for my niggas stuck on the interstate. New Philly, I scream that back till they stretch me. Whoever got an issue, tell them pussies come check me. I'm Joe Pesci, Irishman, shots in the liver. And then we throw the pistol in the river, I deliver. Get your big homie hit with you too, group discount. Legendary uptown, you boys better slow down. Homie telling these tall tales, I get him cut down. Bro, give us the lowdown, it goes and it comes round. All that liquor and that dirt that y'all smoking. Ray spark the potent crack a hater head open. Niggas sick, put dick in they chick. That's what you get when the kittens try to hiss at the pit. Get your dumb ass hit with a cartridge. Don't put the pack boys next to the bosses. Cut your losses.
Load it, cock it, fire. Then reload it again. Load it, cock it, fire. Then reload it again. Load it, cock it, fire. Then reload it again. Load it, cock it, fire. Then reload it again.
From the sidelines, I know it's hurting the crowd. Me and my hoes, we was on Broad Street every week on the back of the bikes. Packing my panties, steady speed, and we was crossing those city lines. Bitch, I'm so Philly, up and down the boulevard like 45 million times. Said she don't like me, I heard that shit like 45 million times. Talking about my back, but they never back that shit up. Checking my camera when I back my shit up. They pull out the cameras when I'm backing my shit up. She not really with shit, but I love when these hoes act tough. Shit got rough, but I never gave up, I held my ground. Talking beef, then you know we leaving that beef ground. Say you gonna meet me here and there, yo, how do you sound? I got niggas on your block, and they watch you play my shit right now. 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 Right now.
I ain't arguing with you, nigga. And then, go do your thing.
Right now.
I promise God don't be playing fair. I promise you don't wanna take it there. Without a check, I don't leave my lair. Don't touch the check when they leave it there. Watch how these hoes tryna steal the flow. Watch how these hoes tryna steal my cadence. He lost his mind when he smelled my fragrance. I back it up when he send that payment. I make me famous. I like a nigga that's gon' let me shine and still remain nameless. Don't care how they take it, cause he love how I take it. We ain't asking for shit, pick it up and we shake shit. Shit got rough, but I never gave up, I held my ground.
Say you got beef, then you know we leaving that beef ground. Say you gonna meet me here and there, yo, how do you sound? I got niggas on your block, and they watch you play my shit right now. 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 Shit got rough, but I never gave up. I held my ground. Say you gonna meet me here and there. Yo, how do you sound?
How do you sound?
Right now. Right now, right now, right now.
And we're back.
Caught you off guard. And we're back with the CEO Row Experience. I have my special guest, Slay Myers, in the motherfucking building. She decided to come through and get the experience.
Yes, and it's been an experience so far, man.
Hey.
It's been a vibe.
Here we go. That's what I want to hear. The Slay Hama Mama, you feel me?
It's named after me.
Yes,
yay.
Definitely.
And
after
it's very
you.
Good.
Now, we can't break tradition. This is the third segment of the CEO Row Experience. In the third segment, we do something. I do something that I do with every guest, and it's called Finish the Thought. Mm-hmm. I'll start the thought, and you finish it. We'll do a few of those, and then after that, we'll open the floor up to any questions that anybody in the audience would have for you or myself.
Hey.
All right?
I'm down.
So let's go ahead and get started. Yes, I'm good.
Excellent.
I can never stop smiling when
I think about that farm I want to live on so bad.
Mm. Just those thoughts. Is it the crack of dawn, you know, when the sun is rising, it's just crack, you know, and you're sitting out there.
It's the crack of dawn, mm-hmm. rising,
reefer.
And just looking around like, damn, I really made it. That's crazy. Thank you, God. All right, time to chill.
Time to chill. Copy. I can see that. It's,
time
that's
to
really
chill.
Nice. Yeah, you painted that picture. It's very
yeah.
nice. You know how to ride a horse?
Heck no.
All right, we got to learn how to ride some horses.
Yeah.
Yeah, my big behind knows how to ride a horse. I can
And you
got
to know what you're doing, because horses be getting, get off of me. I'm like, ooh.
Well, you know, you got to read certain signs, know if the horse is agitated. Things.
Uh-huh.
No one ever in life needs to get kicked by a horse.
That shit will kick your ass.
Yeah,
I am
that's
good.
Crazy. No, or get bit. You don't want to get bit by a horse either. Yeah, they bite too. Yeah, what?
Oh yeah, we're not pissing the horsies off. We're just gonna let them be.
Yeah, when they're
we're gonna let them be.
Things of that nature. Yeah.
Yeah, I can imagine. They're huge, so I can imagine the damage.
From time to time, it's good to. From time to time, it's good to
detox.
And clarify or go into a little bit more detail with you mean by detox.
And detox can be a lot of things. Like, remember how I told y'all a few minutes ago, sometimes I feel like I be watching too much of that true crime. I just be like, all right, dial it back.
Okay.
Or if you're drinking like too much sweets or too much like juice or, you know, if you find yourself in like a cycle of like, you know, weird thinking patterns and you're just like, hold up.
Bad energy.
Yeah, like, how are we gonna manifest?
I understand completely.
We gotta like.
Yeah, bring it back.
Yeah.
You got to discipline yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Do away with the bad.
And give yourself a break. Sometimes it's good. You be thinking like, I think it's a lack of patience sometimes, at least for me. You be thinking like, oh, I just can't wait to do this again. It's like, it's never going to go away. Just calm down. it's going to come back around. It's just time. Mm-hmm. It's just time. Mm-hmm. You're going to get your moment again. Relax.
From time to time, it's good to. From time to time, it's good to
take a walk with the dogs.
Okay.
Take a walk with the dogs.
Okay. Nature walk.
Yeah.
Breathing in. Do you hug trees?
I haven't done that yet. I'm surprised though.
Okay.
I'm very surprised I haven't done that yet.
We're a tree hugger. We got a couple tree huggers in the building.
I am very surprised.
We got a couple tree huggers.
I admire them though. Like when I think about nature, when it's peaceful and quiet, I just be like, Yeah. I'm surprised I haven't hugged a tree. I should do that.
I'm hearing it's, you know, good vibrations and energies and things of that nature.
Totally my vibe. Barefoot.
Okay. All right. Let's see. I know this is weird, but I really like to.
Okay.
Yeah, that's a great one.
I know this is weird, but I really
like to.
I really like to talk to my dogs in their secret little language.
It's a secret little language.
Well, it's not there. It's like.
Oh shit! Look, I'm sorry.
You just want me to tell you what I tell these dogs so bad.
No,
it's like baby voices. You know when you have your baby and it's like baby.
Oh shit!
And you got like little nicknames for them and.
You be wanting them to lick you and stuff like that while you're talking to them.
I have one
voice.
Dog that's obsessed with like licking my ankles. I think that's his way of like showing love. The short one, Chubby.
Okay.
He's like, he's older too, so I think he's just always trying to like, I'm frail. Give me love.
Oh, shit.
Give me love.
Yeah, and you give it to him. You
know, yeah.
You're speaking his language.
Yeah. I think that's cool. People probably might think she's so like weird. I'm like, so.
Well, people that are animal lovers and probably preferably dog lovers would not probably say that you're weird.
I appreciate
people
y'all.
People do, I'm sure you do. People, you know, they go to extremes. They dress their dogs up. They let the dog get in their bed.
Oh, yeah. See, there's boundaries. my one dog, he ends up in my bed overnight, but you know, I clean their feet and stuff. I don't know if y'all know.
Are they house dogs?
Kind of. I take them out every day. They walk every right. day, but they're mostly in the house.
Do they live outside? Like, is the doghouse outside or do they sleep in the house?
They sleep in the house.
They're house dogs.
Okay, so they house dogs. Oh yeah, they my babies. I don't crate train. I never did the crate training. I have more anxiety than them.
Right. Copy.
Yeah.
All right, I understand. Yeah, they're really your friends.
Yeah.
Yes. They're there to hear and bark at you when you respond to your true crime shoes and shit like that. Like, did you see that chubby?
I have a guard dog too, the bigger one. He's one, Batista. He's a Rottweiler.
Okay.
Rhodesian Ridgeback and a Black Moth Cur, so he don't play. Right. Woo, he in the house. I'm like, yes.
Okay.
That's one of my prized possessions. His name is Batista. Okay. I named him Batista because I knew he was going to be regal and mighty.
Okay.
Yeah.
Copy that.
Yeah.
That's really.
Yeah.
Took pride in that.
I told you, I'm very wholesome.
Okay.
Very wholesome. Very like, you know, just chill.
All right.
Yeah.
So this will bring on the next one. When I'm alone, I like to
think a lot. A lot. I prefer to be in my head, to be honest. I'm not going to hold you. I prefer to be in my head working things out, planning, writing songs. Right. I prefer to be in here. And to be honest.
To make it make sense.
Yeah, I like being in here. Mm-hmm. I come out sometimes and they're like, my real name is Tracy.
Okay.
That's another thing too. Yeah. They be like, Tracy, I'm like, huh? Oh yeah.
Tracy.
I'm always in my own world.
Right.
Yeah. I pay attention when it's necessary.
Heavy introvert.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just really like being in here. I just like coming up with solutions, you know?
Okay.
Once I discovered that was a possibility, now I just live there. Mm. Now I just live there.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, let's do. This is the last and final one. Today will be great because
I woke up.
No doubt.
Yeah. I woke up, we woke up, and we got a chance to do things over. If we made a mistake yesterday, it's like, fuck, all right, it's cool. I'm not holding it against yourself. We learning. We holding ourselves accountable. It's cool. It's cool.
Right.
At least you know, like.
I got a chance to make it right.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
That's all what right. makes me excited.
Well, today is great to me because you're on the CEO Role Experience. You already know.
Ditto.
No doubt.
Ditto.
And everybody else that has come to support the CEO Role Experience, thank you for coming out. And that will conclude the Finish the Thought segment. So now we're going to go ahead and jump into the question and answer segment with the audience. If there's anybody that would like to ask a question, please come up, state your name, and ask your question, please. Thank you.
I love it! Slamming,
son.
Hey.
Lucci.
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 What's up, mamas?
I got two questions for you.
Let's go.
What made you want to do another version to Confessional?
I've always, like, even when I was younger, my friends used to make fun of me, like, you always trying to, like, break things down and do an acoustic version. I'm just obsessed with, like, either, like, a piano and, like, a guitar and a voice. Mm. I feel like that's so, especially as a singer, that's just a way where you can switch the song up and be more intimate. I just felt like I wanted to sing it a different way. Cause even when I was singing it the first time, you know, cause it was produced and everything, I was just like, all right, you know, when you write in the song, it gotta be a certain cadence, key, whatever. I was like, all right, when you just open it up, just go crazy. So that's why I did it. I wanted something new. I wanted to like exercise my voice a little bit and just do something different.
I like it, it's kind of like old school vibe.
Yeah. I had Lauryn Hill MTV Unplugged playing in my brain. Wow. You know, when she was doing the, I gotta find my peace of mind.
Right.
And she was all like hoarse, yeah. But she sounded fire.
Yeah, it was raw. I remember that. That's dope, that's dope.
Come on, like y'all getting me too hype right now.
Like getting too hype.
My second question for you is, you say you wanna be on the farm, so what kind of animals is we having on the farm?
Girl, did the works. As much as I can afford to properly care for and have them live like Neverland or something. I want cows. I don't eat meat, so they just gonna be nice and fat. I just be imagining that.
You use them for the milk?
What's your favorite animal?
I love dogs. I love them all. Farm animal. I like pigs. Micro pigs, the little piglets, the little horses. They got house horses.
She's like Charlotte's Web out this girl.
No, I saw that. They had this little micro horse running through. I don't know about how they took little care mini. Of it cleanly wise, but he was running through the crib.
Yes.
I was just Thank like, you. That's so dope. But I love pigs. I think they're all adorable, but I want cows, chickens. Mm-hmm. I just want them all to just be free, like in a pasture, and just get fat and be happy. Everybody You're not going to get happy. Eaten. I'm not going to eat you.
You just want them around.
Yeah.
Okay.
To bring the vibes. And I don't know.
The farm experience.
Yeah.
No doubt.
And I have to live someplace warm because I hate the cold. Okay. I got island blood, so I need warmth. I need trees. I need plants. Mm. Yeah, man. Zah. That too. That too.
Just open.
I don't know.
And breathe.
And you know what else? You asked me something earlier. Why do I do this for?
Mm-hmm.
There's another reason I do this too. I remember when I was younger, I used to think, I can't wait to get my mom a house.
Mm-hmm.
I can't wait. I literally be thinking sometimes, like when I be seeing people that like struggle, I'm like, man, I wish I had $1 million already. So I could just like, and it's real. And it's like, I don't, even if they didn't know it came from me, I'd be cool with that.
Right.
I just want to be able to like help people
right.
if possible and just be chilling. You know what I'm saying? Just a good vibe and feel good about that. Like you're able to help people and it's not nothing behind it. Cool.
No doubt.
Yeah.
Would anyone else like to come up and ask a question at this time? Thank you again, sis. Man, we appreciate that. Thank you again, Lucci, for the questions.
Yes. Good questions, too.
Uptown
Wiz.
Hey. The Wizard.
What's good? What's good?
When are you going to drop your next album?
You know what's crazy? I got 3 albums out already. Mm. I told y'all I've been working for a minute.
Mm-hmm.
A minute. Mm-hmm. I ain't know nothing about the business. That's why I ain't blow yet. And I'm learning now.
Mm-hmm.
After I dropped this single, the Confessional, he's like, a lot of people been asking me about that. I am working on a project. Yes, that was Confessional, the regular version. My last album I dropped was in 2020. It was called Exposé. That was the change time when I left my mom's house. I told you I'm a late bloomer. I left my mom's house at 28 years old, and I am not ashamed because.
Are you the only child?
No, I am not. So right after. I have another single planned after this too, but there's another EP in the works, but I'm not gonna like say anything yet. I'd have the title in my brain. I think I could tell y'all. I think it's gonna be called Elevate.
Okay.
Yeah, because the last one
Exclusive
I dropped
shit.
Was called Exposé, and that was during a time when I was like being an adult for the first time, moving on my own, paying bills on my own. Right. It was a lot. Having people, oh my God, y'all don't even know the half. Like, should I tell y'all? I remember when I was in massage school, y'all, man, I was working so hard. I was paying massage school out of pocket. And I decided to go, because I told you I was doing Uber. And I was like, I need like something to hold me because I'm really going to do this music thing. Because I really was serious about it. I'm like, I'm really going to like pull my sleeves up and learn this shit because I really think I have something to work with.
Right.
I was working so hard, y'all. I got a fucking bald spot. It grew back. It grew back. That's how.
Some stress?
A stress spot. Yeah, and I didn't even know that shit until like I graduated massage school. And then I just was like this one day. And I was like scratching my head and I was like, why I feel a little fuzzy? I was like, I don't know. I mean, my hair naturally feels fuzzy because you know, it's natural. I was like, And I looked and I took a picture. I was like, is that flash? I was like, no, that's your scalp.
Oh, shit.
So I learned how to like manage stress and everything. I was like, wow, but it needed to happen. Cause you know how sometimes when you wait in too much and God has stuff for you, it's like all at once. This is overdue.
Right.
So I decided to go to massage school and I was like, I'm really gonna do this. And that's when I made Exposé.
Okay.
That was my Exposé.
Okay.
And if you listen to it, I was exposing everything. Fake ass friends I had at the time, I didn't know. And even the stuff I was going through with my mom, and it was just a lot. And I was just like, man, this is crazy. This is what adulting really is. And I was by myself, a girl at that. And I developed so many like ways of survival. I was just like, don't be Joe. You see all these like different people out here. Don't be all hype. You on your own, protect yourself. And it was like God was telling me, like, you on this journey, be safe. This is how you gonna be safe, et cetera, et cetera. Right. So, in this stage of life, after all of that, 3 years later, here comes the elevate. I'm working, man. There's stuff marinating, and I'm about to talk about a lot, because I feel like I'm always talking about like positivity and manifestation. I feel like there's other parts of me that are probably like a mystery to people, like my personal life and stuff, and I'm just like, well, all right, let's go down that road. Let's go down to how I got to thinking, how I think about relationships and, you know, why I think the way I think and why I don't have kids yet and, you know, why I am the way that I am. So it's going to get deeper. We're going to elevate.
Yeah.
We're going to elevate.
Well, you're in the right direction because I feel like I do the same shit. Like, you got to think. I think most more women are on it, though. Men get it a little later.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But most women are on it early. Not saying men don't get it early too, but most men don't get it till later. But yeah, the manifestations, the focus is coming and just being conscious.
Yeah.
Being open-minded, allowing the change to come in when you know that it's good.
And
you
it's intense change. You'd be like, wait.
Yeah, life is a motherfucker, man.
The people you thought that was going to be around forever, it's like, wow, this story's so different now, man.
Facts.
Oh my God, and I can't go back.
Facts.
I can't go back because they were never supposed to be apart for this long.
And you want to know, I agree. I feel like we all have been through it.
Of course, we all.
I'm a Scorpio. I'm not really in the zodiac, but as I got older, I started to get into it, you know, hence the people that are around me.
Intensity.
Right. It's just, I'm a very loyal individual. I am intense.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I'm an intense individual, but I'm very loyal. People take advantage of that shit.
Yep.
You feel what I'm saying?
Yep.
and they know it, and it worked for them more than it worked for me.
You're loyal
and
to others more than yourself.
I was loyal to a default, and then I had to realize, like, no, like, if you're not moving the way that I'm moving or giving the same energy, not saying you have to be like me. We know we're individuals, but, you know, when it comes to our relationship, if you're not putting in what I'm putting in, then I can't fuck with you. You dig me? Because what am I getting really from you or out of this situation? Who's really benefiting from out of this relationship?
It should be an equal pour. Like, I'm getting dry, give me some water, I'm gonna give you some water too, so we don't dry.
Exactly. You draw strength. That's the purpose. I feel like that's one of the purposes of having friends. You draw strength from your friends. You dig what I'm saying? Not saying that you're a weak person. You don't gotta be a weak person, but we all have our moments.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, I'm surrounding myself with people that are not gonna let me fall. I'm surrounding myself with people that are gonna allow me to not grow and be the best
me. People that don't want to see you fall either. That's a very important
one.
That's what I'm saying.
Right. Right.
That will go out there and just, no, even when you about to make yourself fall. Mm-hmm. Get out your own way. Mm-hmm. What are you doing to yourself? Get up. Open the curtains, wash yourself, whatever's going on.
Right.
You are better than this.
Yeah, that's real shit.
Yeah. All right, so we're
those are rare. Those are rare.
Okay, Wizard, go ahead, man. Ask away. Go ahead and ask your question.
When is the next show? Because I missed the last one. Hey. Mushrooms.
Oh, shit.
It's real.
He's talking about, I curate a show called Poets and Laughter. I have an event.
7 foot. I can't.
Yeah.
I can't.
Some mushrooms.
I heard some stories about them shrooms. First time?
Yeah, he came at the end like shroomed out. He came at the end of the show shroomed out.
Oh, man.
But he came, though. He still came. He was shroomed out, but he still came. I have a show I put on. It's called Poets and Laughter.
Yes.
Comedy, poetry, hip-hop, R&B, and a little bit of burlesque.
So dope.
You dig what I'm saying? Yeah.
So dope.
So it's a really dope vibe.
So dope.
I did shit because, like I said, life be life and certain things I have to focus on, and that shit is a lot of work because I do it by myself. But I got a team with me, so, you know, 2024, you definitely can look for that to come. I would probably say I'm going to shoot for March.
March?
Hey.
I'm going to shoot for March. I think I can pull it off in March. I got my team with me. I think I can pull it off in March. And we're going to do a poet
before you know it.
And Slay should be on it.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm down.
Definitely, yeah, we go, listen.
We're locked in.
Listen, and then this is crazy because since then I've met a lot more people.
Yeah.
People that I didn't really bang with in the beginning when I first came on, I bang with now, and they, you know, they with me, they fucking with me. So it's this next lineup is gonna be, you know, we in there. And thank you again for coming out, Wiz.
Absolutely.
You know I mean, shout out to my man, Wiz.
Elevate.
Wow. Yes, no doubt.
Time to elevate.
Thank you again, Brody, for coming through. Thank you again, Luch, for coming through. And before we go, because we have to go, because we have to get into this performance.
Yes.
It's definitely been a pleasure to have you on the platform, Queen. In the future, anytime that you would like to come back, let me know. Any new events, anything new that you got going on in your life, if you want to talk about some shit, just let me know.
Absolutely.
Anything you would like us to be a part of, let me know.
Absolutely.
But before we go, please let them know where they can find you at.
So I've had such an incredible time on the show. I'm Slay Myers, singer, songwriter, here to raise your vibes. You can find me on all platforms, Slay Myas, S-L-A-Y-M-A-Y-E-S. That's Facebook, Instagram, Spotify, YouTube, Threads. I'm not on Twitter like that, but whatever you can think of, that's where you can find me. You can even Google my name, just Slay Myas, and you'll see, like, I got a website, too. Forgot to talk about that. I got a website, too, slaymyas.com. Shout out to my brother, Creative Mo, all the way from France, who I met.
Okay.
Over 3 years ago. That's the power of the internet. My brother from another mother. I call him my brother from another mother because he likes it. So that's the power of the internet. He's part of my team. He produced Confessional, actually, the first one. And Confessional, the acoustic version, is featuring another dope artist named Nate Zavitas. Another Zavitas. Dope guitarist. Y'all
He's a
know
part him. Of a band. And what's the name of his band?
Zavitas.
Zavitas.
I like to call him Zavitas.
Yeah. So that's real dope. We gotta tap in with Nathan, correct?
Yo, let me tell you, and he did the damn thing. And I did a post and a bunch of people responded. I was looking for a guitar player and I went with him and I did not regret it. Okay. So y'all can find me. Confessional acoustic version is coming out December 22nd on all streaming platforms.
No, support
I
that.
Might have a visual because you guys know.
Well, we need the visuals.
I'm dramatic.
You know, we got the
I have
top
to,
five videos on Fly Day TV.
You I have to I'm visually saying? Show you guys what I be trying to talk about, what's in my brain, you know.
The last one was good.
Yeah.
The last one was decent.
Thank you. Thank you.
It was.
That's coming out, original version of Confessional that dropped back in May. The video's out for that. I also have a mini documentary called It's My Time that I dropped last year with my single It's My Time. Mm-hmm. And it's only 20 minutes and it's short and sweet. And I did that because I was like, when people start coming in, I want y'all to be able to have something to like get to know me a little bit and where I came from and realize this is not a gimmick, this is not a fad.
No doubt.
This is my love, this is my passion. Through all the craziness. So I'm Slay Myas. If you like anything, my vibes, the music that you're gonna hear tonight, follow me, Instagram, Facebook, like I said, all platforms, Slay Myas, and stay tuned for the good vibes.
No doubt. And thank you again, sis, for coming through again, man. We love you here at the CEO Row Experience. It's definitely been an experience. Make sure you tune in every Monday and Wednesday from 7 to 9 p.m., man, because you're now rocking with the best, man.
Hey.
What else is there to do but come and get the experience in the flesh?
Hey.
Your boy, CEO Row. And then you can catch me again every Fly Day from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. with the rest of the Fly motherfuckers, a.k.a. the Fly team. You dig what I'm saying? Powered by Glockaware. This is how we do it. You feel what I'm saying?
Yes.
Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back with a performance from Miss Slay Myas.
Yes. Hey, Slay Myas here to perform Confessional, the acoustic version on CEO Row Experience. Hey. I see your eyes on me, glowing green with envy. You look at me and think I'm perfect, like I got it all together. Ooh, and so talented and pretty is she. What in the world could be so rare to me? And in your eyes on me, some days it feels like I'm losing this game. Here's my confessional, it ain't always rainbows and sun. I'm way more sensitive than meets the eye. But
know I'm not alone. Here is my confessional. When it rains, it pours, asking me how I am so positive, wondering how I am so confident. It comes from years of feeling like nothing. I'm still battling some demons, and deliberately I force myself to see me as a thing of beauty. But sometimes all I see are flaws, and I stumble and fall. No. But I'm working on my stuff, and I know I'll overcome. Yes, I will. Yeah, 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 yeah. Don't always shine. Break it down. Don't always, always shine. Oh, the drama. Don't look at me.
One, two, get down. Call to be the boss.